असतो माँ सद्गमय, तमसो माँ ज्योतिर्गमय, मृत्योर्मामृतं गमय। ओम शांति शांति शांति। डियर पार्टिसिपेंट्स, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, व्हाट इज द प्रेजेंट टाइम्स लाइक? लेट मी ड्रॉ अ क्विक स्केच इन द फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ माय प्रेजेंटेशन। Then, in the second part of my presentation, I will outline the concept and philosophy of managing self. It's a global world. In the age of information and communication technology, the concept of distance is becoming redundant. The difference between domestic and foreign, national and international, is getting blurred, and it is very good indeed. The world is shrinking into a single global village, a single global market, a spaceship Earth, and perhaps into a single family as envisioned by our Indian sages. उदार चरितानाम तु वसुधैव कुटुंबकम। गो ग्लोबल इज द बज़वर्ड फॉर द मिशन टुडे। फॉर एन एग्जांपल, आई ब्रिंग अ न्यूज फ्रॉम टाइम्स ऑफ इंडिया ऑफ 14/9 लास्ट ईयर। दिस इज अ न्यूज आई प्रेजेंटेड टू यू। The Reliance is looking to buy thousands of hectares of land in Brazil, on which it will grow sugarcane to produce ethanol, a substitute for gasoline. And there is a gaggle of Indian businessmen looking for opportunities in the sprawling country of 85 lakh square kilometers. Pharma, mining, oil exploration and railway firms feel boundless possibilities there. Among them are Tata, AB Birla Group, ONGC, Ranvexi, Wockhardt, Dr. Reddy's and scores of others. And friends, the bilateral trade between the two countries has increased fivefold from $500 million in 2002 to $2.5 billion in 2006. The happy truth is that, and I'm happily emphasizing this point, the happy truth is that Indians are looking for opportunity anywhere on the earth. The globe is larger, reachable, feasible, and happier for Indians. Naturally, technical education is very much under the bittersweet process of globalization. Changes, unpredictable, are coming with accelerating velocity from multitude of directions unknown, encompassing economic, social, and political, psychological and cultural, and even spiritual and celestial life. Let us look at the main news from page 1 of certain newspapers of yesterday, Sunday, the 22nd July. The first page of Tribune: Pratibha is president, defeats Shekhawat by a big margin. And she is to go where no woman has gone before. She would become supreme commander of Indian Armed Forces. 1-2-3 deal signed and sealed. Now this is concerning civilian nuclear agreement. Militants attack Amarnath Yatra. Proof against Dr. Hanif incorrect. wild over Harry. And a reader says, I could not stop myself from finding out the end first. Harry Potter is as much in news as Pratibha Patil. And then there is a news about coaches to train people in garbage collection. Look at the change. Then Times of India. After 300 hours, a deal. This is again regarding that nuclear deal. Cross voting gives Pratibha huge win. Cross voting gives Pratibha huge win. And there is a cartoon where Pratibha is standing and Sonia Gandhi is telling her, you have come a long way, baby. Then there is a news, woman paramour held in NRI murder case. NRI murder case. What a kind of globalization. Hanif detained on wrong information. Abducted trader rescued from Amritsar. Harry Kane. Potter army storms stores in dawn raid. Cloud burst washes away bridge in HP. 15 hurt in attack on Amarnath Yatra. Tribune reports 10 hurt. Times of India reports 15. Generally, there is difference in figures quoted by newspapers. I don't know why. Then there is Dainik Bhaskar. It has only two news on the main page. One is Pratibha ki Mahamahima. Antaratma ki Awaz ka NDA card ulta pada. Kai rajyon mein hui cross voting. And then Harry Potter. Harry salamat, diwane khush. Then Economic Times. I am quoting from yesterday's newspapers. Transfer pricing rules likely to be fine-tuned, regime to be aligned with mature jurisdictions like US, UK, Japan. Slimmer PSUs show the way. This is very important news. Slimmer PSUs show the way. Post-liberalization, state-owned biggies, IOC, SAIL, HPCL, BPCL, notch up 10 times more revenue with fewer staff. ICICI quarter one net profit up 25% at rupees 775 crore. Actually, something remarkable has happened in the new millennium regarding the corporate world. Every year the profits are going up on the average by more than 30%. Economic Times also reports Pratibha becomes first woman president. And then a news about Harry Potter. Freedom from deathly suspense at dawn. You know, there was a suspense regarding whether Harry will survive or he will die. And you know, people are so happy that Harry did not die in this fiction. The fiction has become a reality. It's quite a change. From Delhi to Mumbai, Bangalore and Kolkata, Potter magic casts a spell across the country. This is psychological change. Many old people like me haven't seen any book of Harry Potter. For us, it is not that significant. But for teenagers, Harry Potter is much more significant than Pratibha Patil. Tremendous change. ₹100 crore fund to help in core public-private participation projects. This is a remarkable event in the economic life of the country, public-private participation. And you see the fruits around. Then there is the news regarding that nuclear deal. Breakthrough reached in Indo-US nuclear deal. Merger of Air India and Indian will be successful, says Patel. Indian companies chase global brands. And duty-free stores roam. Whenever there is competition, there is possibility of row. So there is row among duty-free shops at the airports. And then big news regarding sex. Pleasure redefined. Now, Economic Times gives this news on page 1. Pleasure redefined. Condom manufacturers are saying Indians prefer protection with generous dose of variety thrown in. Yes, friends, changes, unpredictable, are coming with accelerating velocity from multitude of directions unknown, encompassing economic, social, and political, psychological, and cultural, and even spiritual and celestial life. We must appreciate the kind of world in which we have to manage ourselves. So some more examples, very important examples. Scientists are discovering new planets. Space and geography are being redefined. The history created by Sunita Williams and nearly as much by Kalpana Chawla is fresh in our memory. Who would have imagined Geeta and Samosa would have a long trip into the space? Shivalingam of ice at Amarnath was not formed last year. It was formed this year but melted much faster than expected. Rajasthan was flooded last year and has been flooded this year too. Lalu Yadav is a professor of management sought after by IIM, Yale and Harvard. Gurcharan Das, you know Gurcharan Das, he has called him the Indian Ronald Reagan. And above all, it is the age of terror with all kinds of innovations. Changes, puzzling changes, as if it is Alice in Wonderland. Alice says, how puzzling all these changes are. I am never sure what I am going to be from one minute to another. It is a world of change and uncertainty. The only constant that remains is change. And the only certainty that remains is uncertainty. Where Josh Malihabadi would say, Kaisa ye ajab daur nazar aata hai, badla badla sa har taur nazar aata hai, aaine mein ye main nahi hoon ae josh, boodha boodha sa koi aur nazar aata hai. Hum boodhe log jab sheeshe mein dekhte hain to vishwas nahi hota ki hum hi hain. the strategy of growth and development. This is a very meaningful statement. The strategy of growth and development adopted by humankind has unleashed interacting competitive forces. Under the pressure of these forces, individuals and organizations, including academia, you and I, are continuously searching for dynamic equilibria. Threats and opportunities are being defined and redefined, and defined, redefined dynamically. So are strengths and weaknesses. It is a world of hope and despair. To quote Harivansh Rai Bachchan, friends from UP, Kabhi nirasha ka tam ghirta, chip jata madhuka pyala, छिप जाती मदिरा की आभा, छिप जाती साकी बाला, छिप जाती मदिरा की आभा, छिप जाती साकी बाला, कभी उजाला आशा करके प्याला फिर चमका जाती, आंख में चोनी खेल रही है मुझसे मेरी मधुशाला, आंख में चोनी खेल रही है मुझसे मेरी मधुशाला. IBM came out with a study in September 2006. It is based on a survey of 765 business executives and public leaders world over. Two-thirds of the respondents expected fundamental changes in their organizations over the next 2 years. Within 2 years, fundamental changes. And the mantra of change is innovation. The report identifies collaboration, partnering. Each word is important. Collaboration, partnering, and technology. Integration. And these are inexorably linked to innovation. It tells about the setting of the industry. What is the setting of industry in future according to the IBM study? The report says the setting is the rise of new economies like China and India, technological advances, intensified competition, and globalization. My dear friends, our pupils, young men and women, must be seeing rainbow of colorful dreams. And many of you are young, you must also be seeing colorful dreams. But are we preparing them or ourselves for that world? It's the world of technological revolution. Since you are engineers and very technical people, I thought that we should talk about this technological revolution a little in detail. Scientists are seeing clear possibility of revolutionizing the way humans work, communicate and live with the help of new inventions, innovations and technology. New hopes created by genetics, medicine, surgery, and nanotechnology are mind-boggling. For example, Ray Kurzweil has recently predicted death will meet its nemesis through nanotechnology in 2020 circa, and humanity will find immortality. And people say his predictions come true. And he believes in his predictions so much that he has started living inside his house. He doesn't go anywhere. He doesn't take any food so that he could somehow survive up to 2020. And he gives the details of how it would be possible. Friends, internet is changing business, government, economy, and society, and the way individuals or organizations operate. Letter E is making presence felt everywhere. E-commerce, e-governance, e-business, e-media, e-HR, e-communication, e-book, e-journal, e-resource, e-revolution, e-bomb, e-boiling, e-waste, e-nose. This is some technical institute in Punjab. मैं नाम भूल रहा हूँ. दो students ने कोई एक device, electronic device develop किया है जो car में fit है और वो smell कर लेगा कि आप कितने drunk हो. And if you are drunk beyond a limit, then you cannot start your car. That they have called as e-nose. Then there is e-attendance, e-mail. There could be e-female as well. There is e-student, e-teacher, e-marriage, and e-after-marriage. And speed of communication is amazing. I do not remember the numbers measuring the velocity of communication. But Ghalib won't write now. लिखा ना उसने, मैंने माना कि तगाफुल न करोगे लेकिन खाक हो जाएंगे हम तुमको खबर होने तक. अब खबर तो फौरन हो जाती है. बाद में ये आप बेशक कहो कि हमारा मोबाइल साइलेंट पर था या ऑफ था, बट खबर तो हो जाती है. अ गेम ऑफ कोलैबोरेशन एंड कॉम्पिटिशन इज ऑन बिटवीन ह्यूमन ब्रेन and computer. As back as in 1999, Deep Blue, a computer, defeated chess genius Garry Kasparov. This you would know better than I know. The speed of computers is belying the Moore's law. Accuracy and area of application of computers is increasing at mind-blowing rate. And friends, there are benefits and there are costs. Stephen Hawking, a modern physics prodigy who is compared with Einstein, has recommended in an interview to a German magazine, Focus, that humans change their DNA through genetic modification. Change your DNA through genetic modification in order to keep ahead of advances of computer technology and stop intelligent machines from taking over the world. Challenge of change and opportunities. The new dimensions of global changes are particularly significant for India and Indians, as these open up opportunities in areas in which we Indians have a definite competitive edge. A report from Goldman Sachs predicts that India would be the only economy in the world growing in excess of 5% annually till 2050. Population is not a burden. It's an asset. I wrote an article, Professor Anand, I did write an article in mid-70s that population is an asset. And I had developed the logic. And I gave it to, I was young at that time, I gave it to one of my professors. And he said, Singh, तुम ठीक कह रहे हो लगता है, लेकिन अगर तुम इसको कहीं छापोगे, तो अगर किसी ने छाप दिया तो लोग यही कहेंगे तुम्हारा दिमाग खराब हो गया है. बट नाउ पीपल आर रियलाइजिंग दैट पॉपुलेशन इज एन असेट. सो गोल्डमैन एंड सैक से दैट the only economy in the world growing in excess of 5% annually till 2050. In fact, it could be more than that. India is expected to have a competitive advantage of labor costs, which would be sustainable up to 2050. India's growth rate is expected to exceed China's by 2010. India will be third richest behind China and USA by 2050. And our Chidambaram says that it would be by 2020. India's youthfulness would increase savings rate and encourage flow of capital from aging nations. Thomas Friedman, author of the bestseller, The World is Flat, said, India and China are on two superhighways, but there is a political bump ahead for China. India road is smooth. There is a lot of comparison between India and China. Comparison emerging from inferiority complex, but there are areas where we are ahead of China. And knowledge resource technology is one area. Information technology, not technology, information technology. And then this important thing. This great author, Thomas Friedman, says that there is a political bump ahead for China and India road is smooth. The image of India in the global society is changing. It is a matter of pride for us that Indians are in the vanguard of the computer-savvy world. They are responsible in a significant way for improving the performance of computers at an incredible pace. Indeed, they dominate the world of computers. In 2002, I wish I could get latest data, but this is data of 2002, 34% of the employees of Microsoft, 28% of IBM, and 17% of Intel were Indians. And there was a story which came in the newspapers, I must tell you. When there was Janata government in India, Nani Palkiwala was ambassador, Indian ambassador in United States. So the IBM chief invited him to visit IBM. He went there and he introduced the intellectuals, the brain, Indian brains, and praised them. And he said that IBM is IBM mainly because of these Indians. And then he turned back to the ambassador and he said that with this kind of intellectual capability, you Indians must be working very hard to remain backward. And remember that we are still working very hard to remain backward. Whatever is happening is not because of these politicians, it is in spite of the politicians. The intellectual capital. R.A. Mashelkar, all of you know him, wrote in 2005, this came in Indian Management, an article came in Indian Management. During the last 7 years, more than 150 major companies from the US and Europe have set up their research, design and development centers in India. And they include big names such as Boeing, DuPont, Daimler Chrysler, General Electric, General Motors, Intel, IBM, Microsoft, Siemens, and Unilever, and so on. Why is this so? The answer was given by the legendary Jack Welch. India is a developing country, but it is a developed country as far as its intellectual capital is concerned. We get the best intellectual capital per dollar here. Cheap labor cost. Mashelkar continued, out of 2,400 professionals in GE's R&D center in Bangalore, 700 were young Indians who have decided to leave the US and join this center. Kiran Karnik, the NASSCOM president, told Mashelkar, he quotes that in his article, that more than 25,000 professionals, 90% of them were IT professionals, had returned from abroad during the last 3 years. Mashelkar called it brain gain. I would prefer to call it brain regain, because this is the brain that we had drained. Now it is coming back. New hope. The world recognizes the competitive edge of Indians as regards the knowledge resource, the resource which is the most dominant propeller of growth today. It's not capital, it's the knowledge resource. And in fact, it's a new emphasis, even the older time economists knew it. The large population, young, skilled and knowledgeable, determines the sustainable competitive edge of India. India is in an exciting position, perhaps more than 1947, as claimed by Azim Premji of Wipro in a lecture 2 years back. He was here in Chandigarh. He said it in that hall of CII. Engineers and technocrats are the most valuable resource in which India excels. Friends, the teachers of engineering colleges and polytechnics, you are the creator of that resource. And lies ahead a bright future for you, but it is going to be difficult. I am tempted to quote a few lines of a poem written by Neeraj. Gopal Das Neeraj. He wrote long time back, Tum mat meri manzil aasan karo. Hain phool rokte, kaante hame badhate. Maruthal pahad, chalne ki chaah badhate. Pagme gati hoti hai, chhale chilne se. Tum pagpag par jalti chattan dharo. Tum mat meri manzil aasan karo. मत मेरी मंजिल आसान करो. एंड हाउ यू मैनेज सेल्फ विल डिटरमिन योर रोल एंड हाउ सक्सेसफुल यू आर. लेट मी एलबरेट ऑन दैट. इन फैक्ट देर आर मेनी वेज ऑफ अप्रोचिंग द सब्जेक्ट, बट I would like to take it as a component of emotional intelligence, managing self as a component of emotional intelligence, which Professor Anand mentioned in the introductory session. And also I see a special session on emotional intelligence. What I'll do, a brief introduction of emotional intelligence, and then I'll elaborate on managing self as a component of emotional intelligence. And I'll base my presentation on the work done by a management guru called Daniel Goleman. Harvard Business Review is a Bible of management. And he published an article on what makes a leader. A political neta nahi. Theek hai? What makes a leader? And by chance, I happened to read that article. And when I read this article, I was so impressed that emotional intelligence is perhaps the most important concept of management. What is this emotional intelligence? Let's look at it. I quote from Daniel Goleman's, the original article. He has published quite a few things afterwards, but I don't know what would be the opinion of Professor Anand, but for me that article still remains the best. Management guru Daniel Goleman wrote in 1998 in the celebrated HBR article, What Makes a Leader? Every business person knows a story about a highly intelligent, highly skilled executive who was promoted into a leadership position only to fail at the job. Why? The answer, although a genius and expert, this person who failed, he lacked emotional intelligence. He wrote in continuation, and they also know a story about someone with solid but not extraordinary intellectual abilities and technical skills who was promoted into a similar position and then sold. Why? The answer, although an average man, he possessed high emotional intelligence. Again, Goleman wrote in 2002, that was 1998. In 2002, he came out with a book, Primal Leadership, Realizing the Power of Emotional Intelligence. He writes there, great leaders move us, they ignite our passion and inspire the best in us. When we try to explain why they are so effective, we speak of strategy, vision, and powerful ideas. But the reality is much more primal. Great leadership works through the emotions. IQ versus EQ. On the basis of extensive global studies on competencies that make successful leaders, Goleman and others found, I quote, no doubt intellect and cognitive skills were important, but emotional intelligence proved to be twice as important as others for jobs at all levels. Note, emotional intelligence was twice as important as IQ. Nearly 90% of the difference between profiles of star performers and average ones was attributable to emotional intelligence factors. And note this, emotional intelligence played an increasingly important role at highest levels of the company, where differences in technical skills were of negligible importance. कुछ अपना पर्सनल एक्सपीरियंस शेयर करते हैं. आई नो क्वाइट अ फ्यू पीपल हु वर टॉपर्स इन देयर क्लासेस, बट व्हेन इट केम टू टीचिंग दे वर नॉट दैट सक्सेसफुल. आई हैव नॉट कम अक्रॉस एनी scientific study on this, but I believe that emotional intelligence will determine success of a person as a teacher, perhaps more than the success of a manager. And if an intellectual is promoted to the post of a principal, there is every likelihood that he will flop. And the poor fellow doesn't realize it. He is living in his past. कि मैं तो इतना तगड़ा student था, मैंने इतने papers publish किए, मैं इतना अच्छा researcher हूँ, मेरी बात को क्यों नहीं मानते लोग. मैंने ऐसे भी लोगों को देखा है जो पागल हो गए. मेरा अपना एक friend था. जब स्टेटिस्टिक्स कर रहा था तो देयर वाज अ फ्रेंड ऑफ माइन, ही स्कोर्ड मच हायर देन आई स्कोर्ड. देन ही डिड पीएचडी इन क्वालिटी कंट्रोल फ्रॉम रुड़की एंड ही केम टू पंजाब यूनिवर्सिटी एज ए लेक्चरर. एंड विद इन अ ईयर ऑफ दैट आई फिनिश्ड माय पीएचडी फ्रॉम यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ कोलोराडो. And I joined the same department as a reader. Now he did not know what is happening. And he would tell me, मैंने उसको कहा कि भाई तुम 64 की बात कर रहे हो ना, 64 में let's take it that you were better than I was. लेकिन अब तो ये 73 है. In these 9 years, you don't know what I have done. But he won't understand it. And he was really so frustrated, he resigned from the job from here, and he went to Canada, and he could not do anything there. He disappeared. We don't know where he has gone. He was a good statistician. But he believed that if he scored first class in MSc statistics, he must be better than someone who scored less. And I have seen many people whom I found they were less intelligent than I was, and they are much ahead of me. पहले मैं सोचता था कि ये कुछ हेरा फेरी करते होंगे, ठीक है. अच्छा, बाद में जब मैंने डेनियल गोलमैन को पढ़ा तब मेरे समझ में आया कि नहीं, ये हेरा फेरी नहीं है. दीज पीपल आर इमोशनली मोर इंटेलिजेंट, दे आर एबल टू मैनेज सेल्फ बेटर देन आई एम एबल टू, देयर फॉर दे आर अहेड ऑफ मी. एंड देयर क्वाइट अ फ्यू पीपल हु आर बिहाइंड मी, इट इज बिकॉज आई हैव मैनेज सेल्फ बेटर देन दे. एंड आई वॉज अ वेरी हैप्पी पर्सन. दैट्स वाई आई एम इम्प्रेस्ड बाई दिस कंट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ डेनियल गोल्डमैन एंड अदर्स. And maybe you will know more about emotional intelligence from some professors. Is Jitendra Mohan going to do that? Dr. Huh? Achcha, achcha. There is a lady who's recently finished her PhD. Under the guidance of Jitendra Mohan and Meenakshi Malhotra of management. And Jitendra Mohan is a professor of psychology. in the university, very eminent man. What is emotional intelligence? I think best way of describing what is emotional intelligence is through an ancient Indian story. It is from one of our scriptures, the story of four learned men that is of four pandits. You know, pandit means learned, and pandit has a colloquial meaning also. Perhaps the reason was that pandits became so big pandits that they were cut off from the real life. So pandit got another meaning. Could be the reason. Now these four pandits had studied in a reputed university, reputed Gurukul. They were specialists in their respective fields of study. They were returning home after getting their degrees with honors. They were well groomed to excel, ready to use their technical skills and compete. On the way, they were passing through a jungle. They saw on the ground some scattered bones. One of them identified the bones were of a lion. इतने कहा ये तो शेर की हड्डियां हैं. इतना knowledgeable था, समझ गया हड्डी देख के कि ये शेर की हड्डियां हैं. The second said, I can reassemble the bones to form the bone structure of the lion's body. And he did it elegantly. The third said, I can put flesh and skin on the bone structure. मैं मांसपेशियां सजा दूंगा इसके बोन स्ट्रक्चर पर. He did it so well that now there was a dead lion lying on the ground. The fourth, the university topper, claimed, I am the best. I will breathe life into the dead body. An old villager was watching them all doing things with perfection. He was astonished, this old villager. He was astonished by the excellence of the three learned men in their trades. He had reason to believe that the fourth learned man must surely be able to do what he was claiming. So, this villager, he requested the pandit not to breathe life into the lion. Panditji, please. इसको जिंदा मत करो. बट द पंडित्स डिड नॉट लाइक एन एडवाइस फ्रॉम एन अनएजुकेटेड विलेजर. तू गवार हमारे बीच में तू कौन होता बोलने वाला. द विलेजर प्लीडेड रिपीटेडली विद फोल्डेड हैंड्स इन वेन. ये बड़े बड़े पंडित कहां मानते हैं. द पंडित्स वेर एडमेंट इन द एज ऑफ कॉम्पिटिशन एंड वन अप मैनशिप. The fourth pandit had to show that he was indeed the best. Then the villager requested him to please wait for a while so that he could climb up a tree. The pandits agreed to wait. The villager climbed up a tree. And the pandit successfully breathed life into the lion. What would have happened? Again, there were bones of four learned men. What is the message? The pandits were intelligent experts, but lacked emotional intelligence. They lacked wisdom, in fact. The old man was wiser, emotionally intelligent. Let's remember Mahatma Gandhi for his emotional intelligence. We will celebrate his 137th birthday in October, very soon. he was surrounded by many who were intellectually much superior to him. But the leader was Mahatma Gandhi, and so effective he had a sway of almost a dictator. In fact, वो साबरमती आश्रम में मैं बहुत पहले की बात है 60s में गया था, तो वहां पे आश्रम में एक लेटर पड़ा हुआ था. उस लेटर का जो एड्रेस था, जानते क्या लिखा था? किसी बच्चे ने लेटर लिखा था, महात्मा गांधी द डिक्टेटर ऑफ इंडिया. दिस वॉज द एड्रेस एंड दिस लेटर वॉज देयर इन द संग्रहालय. इट इज फ्रॉम देयर दैट आई पिक्ड अप दिस दैट ही हैड अ स्वे ऑफ ऑलमोस्ट अ डिक्टेटर. उनकी बात नहीं मानते थे तो लोग वो क्या करते थे, सत्याग्रह कर देते थे. आजकल भी सत्याग्रह के बारे में बड़ा आता है टेलीविजन पे. व्हाट वाज हिज स्ट्रेंथ? देयर कुड बी मेनी, बट वन द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट वाज हिज हाई इमोशनल इंटेलिजेंस. ऑल द बेस्ट. थैंक्स फॉर द पेशेंस.